Hi, my name is Dr. John Shim, and I want to discuss lumbar microdiscectomy. By now, you've already tried non-surgical treatments and have decided to move forward with the operation. Lumbar microdiscectomy surgery is offered because your pain patterns and physical examination matches the findings on your diagnostic studies. Let me show you a typical lumbar MRI of a disc herniation. This is the sagittal view. It is a side view of your back. For most patients, there are some normal disc levels, but the offending disc shows a mass pushing backwards on the spinal sac with potential to irritate specific nerves. The axial view or the cross-sectional view will provide another angle to visualize the offending disc. For some patients, there may be also associated bone spurs that contributed to the nerve irritation, and a surgeon must anticipate removal of some of these bone spurs to maximize the chance of a good outcome. Of course, I'm simplifying the procedure. For the surgeon, there are many nuances that need to be considered. Experience helps when planning the operation. Still, the exposure is relatively the same. An incision is made just off the midline. Care is taken to preserve the posterior spinous ligament and minimize the stripping of the multifidus muscle attachments. For the average size person, the incision is less than 1.5 inches, but may be larger if more than one disc removal is required. Muscles are gently retracted to allow visualization of the bony covering or lamina and the ligaments that cover over the spinal canal. Magnification is used to better visualize the anatomy, thus micro. Depending on the level, some of the bone will need to be removed to allow access. Tools, including burrs, kerosene punches, and curettes, aid in the removal of the covering bone and ligament. The nerve sac is then identified and protected. The nerve sac and nearby nerves are then gently swept off the offending disc herniation, and the disc herniation is removed and the nerve is now free of pressure. Associated bone spurs may also need to be removed. The wound is then closed. For the properly selected patients without any other medical issues, the success rate of improvement is greater than 90%. For the vast majority of patients, they can resume normal activities within a few months. Most patients now have the operation performed on an outpatient basis. This is the basic anatomy of the lumbar microdiscectomy operation. You should discuss your individual concerns with your surgeon. This is Dr. John Shim, and I hope this video helped you understand the micro lumbar discectomy surgery.